We use balloons for different reasons, different purpose, to make decorations, for entertaining, occupational therapy, art therapy, hands motion coordination, educational purpose. But general uses to make sculptures for decorations and for entertaining. And when we talk about entertaining, the first thing that comes on my mind, games. There are dozens of games that we can play indoor, outdoor, with different number of players. Most games doesn't require any balloon twisting skills. Anyone can play them. Just inflate balloon and play. One game, and actually my favorite game, does require balloon twisting skills. Title of name of this game is Make a Guess What I'm Making. Kind of self-explaining name. It has very simple rules. Players must guess what balloon twister makes while he's making it. And the first player who make a right guess would get the prize, balloon sculpture. Each player can win only one time. If you win more than once, then you have to give a sculpture to someone who doesn't have the balloon sculpture yet. Quite simple rules. One more thing about this game. It's important for balloon twister to keep it alive. Meaning, you have to speak, you have to talk, you have to make jokes while you're making the sculpture. If you don't have anything to speak about, you can always refer to balloons. Explain kids what you're making. This way they'll be more encouraged to participate in the game. Alright, let's do it. Playing this game as a balloon twister, I prefer to use similar looking sculptures. So there are a couple different lines, my favorite lines that I use for this game. And that's what I want to share today with you. So let's start with something simple. Does it look like anything that you know? Sven. Now, make a guess what I'm gonna make next. Someone said swan? No. Well, you can make a swan, but it's not a swan. Head. That's right. It could be this head. It could be that head. Or it could be that head. Whoever said head first, got it. Make a guess what I'm going to make next. Someone said head? Not exactly. Someone said Sven? Not exactly. Sven does not red. But it does look like a Sven and like a head. But I'm gonna make it head. Does it look like anything you know? Not yet. Okay. So we're not making head, and we're not making sweat. Oh, someone already knows the answer. That's right. Elma. Also, we can use blue balloon to make Cookie Monster in the same way, pretty much. Make a guess what I'm going to make next. Not a head, not a swan. So it could be head or swan. Does it look like anything that you know? You're right, a flower. The flower needs stem. And while we're working on a flower, we can make different flowers. Make a guess what I'm going to make next. Not a head. I'm not making head now. Not yet. Well, it could be, but it's not what I'm making. Someone said ball. It is kind of a ball. It could be basketball ball. Or it could be a pumpkin. Whatever you like to make. Flower, and we can make different flowers. Six petals flower. Also, we can use the same six petals flower to make something different. Different flower. Make a guess what I'm going to make next. Like a hat, but it's not. Does it look like anything with you now? Yes, it could be pumpkin, small size, it could be ball, it could be anything. So far, all those sculptures that we made were based on the same threefold head. I call it threefold head line. That's one of my favorite. Also, there is another a line which involves only one balloon, and it's based on chain of four bubbles. In the line of one balloon sculptures, we can use chain of small bubbles to make different sculptures. I mean to use thumbnail size bubbles. It doesn't look like anything, maybe caterpillar. From here we can make it a monkey head, we can use it as a poodle head, or maybe as a rear part of different animals. Here's a tail. Chain of four. From here we can make it a baby giraffe. Or we can make it a doggy. A poodle. Also we can use it to make a little crown hat. has a fancy hat, crown, with 4 points. Also, it could be caterpillar. Snowflake. It could be two kissing dogs. Further one dog. Here's a second dog. Kissing dogs or sniffing dogs. We can split this bubble on two bubbles as well. So what did I make? I don't know. Back to our game. We can use many more sculptures to play this game. And you can find instructions how to make each particular sculpture at fewdoit.com. And when you check in fewdoit.com, I really suggest you to look at Balloon Twisting online resources page. fewdoit.com. That's where you can find links to different websites, different channels of many different balloon twisters, artists, very talented artists. Talking about this game, I would really suggest you to check YouTube users' channels Buster Balloon and David Scott. David Scott stage performance, one of the first videos that he, I think, he published on YouTube. That's where you can get a lot of inspiration for this particular game and definitely for stage performance. Look around, you'll find many more ideas. Pick up your own lines, play it well, have fun and happy twisting.
From my personal experience, I prefer to play this game with all my customers. I make what I know how to make, what is easy for me to make, the customer name it, and I let him win. It's a win-win game for everyone. Of course, instead of playing this game, you can always ask your customer kind of silly question. What balloons do you want? Then you have to figure out how to make it. Good luck with that.